Free and local AI in Home Assistant is now possible thanks to the Ollama project. But how can I install and configure this easily? How can I use it afterwards? Are there any limitations? Let's find out together. In general, we will install Ollama on a laptop, then we will add Ollama integration in Home Assistant, and finally, we will configure Home Assistant Assist to use the Ollama. Ollama is a popular tool that helps us run large language models, or LLM for short. LLMs are AI models designed to understand and generate human language. Some of these LLMs are trained using supercomputers who have read enormous amounts of text data from different sources like books, articles, websites, and all kind of stuff written by people. All of that to learn the nuances and patterns of the human language. The best part here is that these LLM models are freely available over internet in a ready-to-use state, although they probably cost millions of dollars to be made initially. Ollama 2 allows us to download such models for free and to run them on a local computer, which makes the AI experimentation more accessible and fun than ever. I think that is enough for AI introduction. If you need more info about the AI, just ask the AI. I'll open the ollama.com website, and from here I should download the version, the client of the Ollama, and it is available for macOS, Linux and Windows. For Mac and for Linux, you just have to download the package and then to install it as usual. For Linux, there is one liner that should be copied and pasted in the terminal. That's all. After successful installation, you can start the Ollama, for example, by typing the name Ollama with double L. And this is it. This is one cute little llama here in my taskbar, and I cannot do anything else apart from quitting it. I can also open my terminal and I can type commands here. Ollama, and I can run models, I can pull models, I can list them, and I can see the version, and so on and so forth. The next important thing that I have to do is to expose this Ollama installation that is only binded to my laptop over my entire home network, so I can connect to it from my Home Assistant device. And this is very easy. I'll open Home Assistant official website and I'll click on integrations. Then I'll search for Ollama here. And these are the instructions that I will follow. This is available somewhere in GitHub, but that is faster for me to find it out. And here it is actually. For macOS, which I'm using, I should use this line here and I should only change these zeros with my laptop IP. If I'm using Linux, these are the instructions. I have to edit the ollama.service. And then again to change these zeros with my real IP. And we also have instructions for Windows. So depending on your operating system, execute the following things here. I'll do that for macOS. I'll copy this line in my terminal and I'll change these zeros with my IP of this MacBook. My IP is this one. I'll just type it 10.0.0.15 and I'm ready. Now my Ollama is accessible not only from my laptop but from my entire network, and not outside my network, only inside my home network. And I can continue to the next step, which is to open my test Home Assistant. This one is running on a Raspberry Pi 4 with 8 gigs of RAM, and I'll press the C button to invoke this search command bar, and I'll type integrations, and I'll select navigate integrations. If some of the terms that I'm using are not so clear for you, download my smart home glossary, which is full of wisdom, smart home wisdom, and it is totally free. You can find the link on your screen and in the video description. Then I'll click on add integration and I'll search for Ollama. Here it is, this cute llama here. I'll click on it and then I'll type my IP. http://, the IP of my laptop, 11434. Was it that right? Yes. So I'll click submit and now it is working. That means I have to type HTTP, then the IP, then colon, and then the port, the default Ollama port. And now I can select a model that I will use with my Ollama and Home Assistant integration. I can select something from this enormous list. And I'll select this Ollama 2 model. Let me show you something. This is the web page of the Ollama. And I can search here by models, or I can click on this models link. And I can filter them out by popular, most popular, newest, featured, and so on. And if I select most popular, I'll see this Ollama or Ollama 2 model, which is one of the most popular models for human language. It is developed by Meta, which is the company behind Facebook, Instagram, and some others. And it is a very, very well-trained model. The total size of this model is 3.8 gigabytes. And you can run it locally by typing this command in your terminal and you will have it on your laptop. But we don't want that. We want this in our Home Assistant and to use this there. Anyways, this was just a side note. Let's back to the Home Assistant Ollama integration. I'll select this Ollama 2 or Ollama 2 model and I'll click on submit. And that's it. I have Ollama now in my Home Assistant. Oh my god, I'm searching it in the wrong place. Here it is, one entry, and I can configure it. And this is the template, auto-populated template, that is basically discovering all of my devices, entities, and areas, and make it accessible to the Ollama so I can query some stuff that are available in my Home Assistant. And Ollama can answer my questions based on this template. Everything is local here. Nothing is going outside my home network. Don't be afraid that Facebook and Mark Zuckerberg will gather your queries and will know all about your Home Assistant. Though that's not the case. And now the last part is to edit our assist pipeline. For that, I'll go to the overview section. Then I'll click on this assist button. Then I'll click on this down arrow and I'll select Manage Assistants. And these are my assist pipelines. I can add a new one and I can create it from scratch. It is not hard at all, but the easiest way is to edit my default one, which is this one with the star. I'll click on it. And down here in this conversation agent section, I'll click on this down arrow and I'll see my Ollama model, LLM model, which I downloaded using the Ollama Home Assistant integration. I'll select that. From here, I can modify my template if I'm a template guru, but I'm not. If you are, you can change some things here to better suit your needs, but I'll leave the default one. And I'll click on the update button. And I'm ready, guys. I can now start using the LLM. Large language model from Meta, from the Facebook founders, that costs millions of dollars to produce initially, and I can use that locally on my laptop and my Home Assistant, and this is how I can use it. I will click again on the assist button, and now I can start asking questions the same way as I'm talking to real humans. Let's try it out. Show me every device I have. This is a test environment and I'm not having much of a devices here. But here they are. Here are the devices you have in your smart home. Okay, list all areas I have. You have the following areas. How many entities I have down in downstairs. Let's try that way. Stairs, which is one of the area. Downstairs. Like that. It's going to answer. You have four entities. Good. Let's try to ask something else. Who made you? Ours created by the Home Assistant software. What? Does it mean that I'm not using the Llama 2 engine? No, I'm using it. Let's try another question. What is AI? I'm not sure can I ask such general questions, but let's try. It is thinking, yes, artificial intelligence, AI is field of computer science, blah, 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 blah. Okay. What is the state of my kitchen lights? Also my dummy bulb and dummy switch. Let's try that question. The kitchen lights are unavailable. The status of your dummy bulb and dummy switch are also unavailable. That is true, because these are helpers and these are not really a devices. When the sun will set. Okay, it will set in 1832. Who are you? I'm just an AI assistant. Okay, hello AI assistant. For example, tell me what TH meter is showing. It is thinking. TH meter is showing 22 degrees and humidity level of 46%. Good, it answers correctly. What is TH meter? TH meter is a sensor that measures the temperature and humidity levels in a smart home. Okay. Good. And I can use these in my automations and scripts. And of course, I have some limitations here using this Ollama Home Assistant integration. And the first one is I can only query data. I cannot control my smart home using this integration. For now, I believe this will be changed in the future. I hope so. The next limitation that I can think of is that I can use this integration in my scripts and automations, but not as sentence triggers. That means I cannot use my voice to ask these questions and to query this data. I have to type them, which is very, very annoying, and I hope this will be fixed or updated in the future releases. And the last limitation is that at the moment I can only query for devices, entities, areas, and their states. Nothing more. If I ask for something else, I'll receive a negative answer. If you need more info about Home Assistant, then register for my upcoming webinar, which is absolutely free, and the link is on your screen and in the video description. Thank you for watching, subscribe for more, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye!